Hello, I'm Cristian, Application Engineer at Training3D, and today we're gonna do a short demo of our new scan, EinScan Libre. So we have in the background a fuselage, and we're gonna scan it with two modes. The first one will be infrared rapid mode, which has the mode of alignment in hybrid and 1.5 millimeters as resolution. Then we're gonna switch and go in HD mode in 101 laser, and we're gonna scan with texture inside so we'll have more details. So now we can start scanning with infrared rapid mode. We can turn and enter scanning. We adjust the distance and start. Perfect, we have the exterior scan. So we can go now in HD mode and scan the interior. We have selected 0.8 millimeter in resolution and we are gonna scan with a laser. That's great. Now we have the scan data of the whole fuselage, right? So even if the scanner itself is a standalone solution and you've done your scan, what you can do right now with it, you transfer it to your computer, you do a bit of post-processing, and from there you can apply it to your needs, right? So let's see how this is going. Perfect. Now we have started the software ExScan Libre. So how we can transfer the data itself? There are three main modes that we can do it. First, it's wireless, so you can use your router to do that. Second, it's connecting an internet cable directly from the computer to the Libre. Or you can use a USB-C to USB-C to transfer the data itself. So on here, you'll just have to press the connect scanner. The scanner will be automatically seen with a serial number. You press on connect, you'll have a pop-up that you will have to accept. And now you can transfer the data that you need. You will have all of your projects already in here, as well as other information that you might need for the projects. So we're gonna select the project that we already scanned and just import it to PC. Now we have the whole project. On the left side, we are able to see on the project list that we have those two scans that we already done before. An infrared mode with a long range and an HD mode up close with more details. So how we can actually use our data? We have to select it both. We have to do an alignment. And on here, we can select the auto alignment feature. We'll select a fixed window. We will select the object like that has more data. And then the floating window will be the object that has the less data. We're gonna apply it. The software will automatically align the data that we have, converting them into one single file. And after that, we press next and we can exit. So on this side, the alignment has been done. We need a bit of cleanup in order to push it to our other processes. Great. Now that we have the data, we can actually see that we have the point cloud. So in this case, we can transfer it and create a mesh. We can do the mesh by the settings here. We have a lot of parameters, and usually we can just recommend some parameters for an easy, quick mesh. I can apply it, it's going to do the process in the background, and we're gonna have everything that we need with just a few simple clicks. Now we have the mesh, but even if you want to have the mesh already onto the computer and to transfer it directly from the scanner itself, you can also do that. So you can mesh it on the scanner and transfer it on your computer. Why did we do it like this? Because on the computer side, you have more flexibility and more options. So on here, we are able to see the scan data that we have. We can see the colors. We can turn off the color which showed texture. We're able to see inside and rotate a bit. We also have a few options if we want to create some wireframes or other viewing decisions. We have some mesh options on here once we select the mesh itself. So there are some texture alignments, some optimizations on smoothness, depending on what you need. But for now, we're gonna go short. And there are also some measurement tools to measure the scan that you have done. but also a way for us to share the data that we have. We can save it as OBG, STL, or other formats that you might need, or directly export it to your desired software. So we're gonna just save it locally. We're gonna save it as scan and OBG, and we are ready to export it to one of our softwares. So that was all for the short demonstration of EinScan Libre. If you have any other questions, feel free to reach out to us, and see you next time.